Hey everyone, Shawn, Sav Mu at your service today. We're going to be showing you how to stop that glancy, weak slice with your irons. And we're going to show you how to have fun with that and carve them around trees. We're going to carve some effortless draws around the tree today. And stay tuned for the show, man. This is going to be a good one. You don't want to miss it. So a little basics with how to work the ball. The best sport for that is soccer. We're going to be seeing some heavy-duty soccer at the Olympics in the next week or so. And if I was to, you know, wrap a soccer ball around that tree and toward that green, I would approach it from an angle. So it's called angular momentum. I'd be brushing out to the right, and I'd be using the inside of my foot to do that. So the way to do it, the face of the club is simply the inside of your foot. So you turn the inside of your foot. So you notice how I do that. I don't turn the wrist. I turn the club within my hand. So we're going to turn the club, then grip it. So notice I've got my foot that's angled to the inside. See how close that is? And then I'm going to set up in a way that's going to have the momentum of my swing go out to the right. You'll notice that the golf swing is an arc. So if this is my golf swing, it's circulating around my shoulder. And you notice how the club bottoms out underneath the shoulder every time. So if I take both hands together and take my grip, the center of the swing is right here between my clavicles. So as I'm swinging around that sternal notch, notice the low point of my swing starts at the middle of my stance. So from there, it's going to move forward. So if I play the ball a bit back of center, close the face, get behind the ball, now I'm actually angulating my body to kick to the right. So watch this. So I'm going to line up square with this intermediate point, play the ball back. Now I'm going to get behind the ball. See how cool that is? So notice now my club face doesn't look as closed, but it is very close to this path. So notice the blur of my club passing over the ball is moving to the right of this. Now, for most of you, if I say to you, hey, let's see you release to the right of the flag to draw it back to the flag, you're going to look at me going, are you nuts? That ball's going to start to the right and never come back. I don't even know how to bring that back. So we close the face, we swing to the right, and we allow it to release. You're going to feel how the weight of the club is going to release that right hand over the left hand effortlessly without even trying. So we're letting the weight of the club release us to the right of that intermediate point. So let's have a look. I'm staying to the right. I stay to the right. See ya. See how that ball started off to the right of the tree and it's drawn all the way back. It landed just right of the flags and it's cozying up behind the flags. Have a look here on Rapsodo. Notice the shots that I just hit and how they're curving back all the way to the tree. So this is how you do it. You line up very close to the tree. You play the ball back a center. You close the face like you're closing that foot. And then you get your shoulders See how the shoulders, hips, and knees are angled that way? Do an acid test with a nice swing above the ball and see the blur, and the blur is staying to the right of that. So now all I got to do is let it swing through that blur in that direction. And there you have it. It's as simple as that. And it came all the way back. So you notice my divot, how it's swinging out to the right of that. Okay? So don't be afraid. All you got to do is give that thing a closed enough face and it'll come back for you. So let's see how Sav and Mu do with this. So just before Sav gets in the saddle here, when you close the face properly, notice my hands are facing each other. And then when I close the face, the hands aren't moving. See how the club is moving, but the hands aren't? This is not closing the face at all. You haven't changed anything in that relationship, okay? So we're closing just like that. And you'll feel more weight in the lead hand. It feels very strange, but it's not gonna prevent you from swinging the club, all right? And aren't we looking stylish in the process? Sav, this is a gorgeous outfit. Tell me all about this new company that you just found on the internet.
So I found these guys a few months ago. They're called Jaybird, and it's a female-owned business. So they make really, really beautiful clothes for the modern female golfer. But they're super classy, super stylish, but they're also very functional.
So yeah, it's very stretchy.
Very stretchy, so it's amazing. And then I also love my Royal Albatross shoes. They're all handmade shoes from small shoemakers in Portugal and Italy.
That's beautiful.
So if you have any ladies in your life, or you're a lady watching,
and then
you need this.
For the boys, you want the true shoes. Mm-hmm. The most functional on the market. And man, are they, you know.
So stylish.
They're very stylish.
Every time they come out with new models, I see you looking at their website. I'm like, wow, that's nice. That's nice too. I'm like, how do you not want to buy everything?
I know, right?
Yeah. All right, Sav, let's see that effortless draw around the tree. Piece of cake. What a shot. Right back to the tree. So did you guys notice when she set up? Go ahead and do that again. So notice that the intermediate point I'm giving you should just be a hair left of the tree, not more than that, right? So notice when she gets set up how her shoulders, hips, and knees are coming this way. So do a couple of practice swings above the ball. Observe the blur. Is that blur staying to the left?
Yep.
There you go. So throw it through that blur in that direction. Piece of cake. Two shots, two first takes. Well done.
Thank you.
Let's get Mu in here. Let's just check the intermediate point. Come see.
Okay.
You can see that that's just a hair left of the tree.
Yeah.
And then we're going to go even further left of that, so you have a wide berth around that tree.
Correct.
And then we just want to close that face significantly. There you go. And then you're going to effortlessly release to the left of that intermediate point.
Right.
Do a couple of practice swings above it and just watch the blur of the club. Right? Now, as you're doing that, here's a cool part. Did you see where the low point of that blur was?
The low point?
Yeah. So notice if you're doing a practice swing and the low point's way out here, then you know you're going to gouge it.
Right.
Right? So you want to feel like as it's coming down, it's coming down,
it's
bottoming out here, and then it starts going back up again.
Right.
Right?
Yeah.
So it should bottom out in front of the ball, but not too far in front. Not bad. Now that started right on line.
Stay straight.
And it just stayed straight.
Okay.
So this is going to happen to some of you guys.
So I got to close the face a bit
just,
more.
Yeah, close the face plenty more. Show me something that's like 90 degrees closed.
Okay.
Yeah. Right? Now to you, that feels crazy, right?
Right.
Okay.
That's crazy, yeah.
So do one above the ball, see the blur. Nice. Go ahead and let it go in that direction. See what happens. Ha! It just grazed the left side of the tree and overdrew.
Okay, overdrew, okay. Yeah.
Now we got Goldilocks.
Right, yeah, now I can find the
face. Wasn't that cool?
Yeah.
That was fantastic. So just back off of that a smidge, right?
Okay.
So show in the camera what that looks like. Isn't that right? Looks
yeah.
at least 45 degrees closed with a nice closed, with a nice square, strong grip.
Right.
Good. There you go, man. Just an effortless release that way. Ah, there, look at that. So the shot is now drawing a little bit.
Yeah.
So you went back to almost where you were before,
yeah.
but that one drew.
Yeah.
It did. It just didn't draw all the way back. So now just close the face some more.
Okay.
See how we're honing in on this one?
Yeah.
You got it, man. There it is. So it started just a little left and is drawn a little bit.
Yeah.
So did you feel like you stayed to the left on that one? Or did you kind of black out a little bit?
I blacked out a little bit and stayed
All right.
long enough.
That's it.
Yeah.
So close it more.
Yeah.
Because you see, if you feel like it's not closed enough,
yeah.
you can't commit there.
Right.
You won't be able to stay left.
Yeah, that's true.
You see?
Yeah.
So show me what was too closed again before. Like 90 degrees?
Yeah, like this. This is too close.
Okay, so back off of that a smidge.
Okay.
Awesome. Now, just stay left of that intermediate point with your blur. Do one above the ball if you need to, just to confirm that. Right?
Yeah, that's it.
Good, there it is. Good.
It was thin, yeah.
Fantastic. Now, that ball position was just a hair too forward.
Okay.
Just wanted to let you make that little mistake.
Right.
So you felt that. There you go. Same release to the left. And we have a winner.
There you go.
There you go.
Dude, that was the shot.
That was it.
Right? And notice how he's looking on that side of the tree. The ball started left and came right back.
Yeah.
Fantastic.
Thanks, John.
Way to go, man.
Appreciate
now
it.
We got draw.
Yeah.
You guys have draw. See you next week.